Using fertility medication with IUI is a common therapy for couples with infertility. It is relatively cheap and easy to do, so it is often the first treatment tried. Pregnancy rates with IUI are not as high as IVF rates, so how many months should you try IUI before moving on? What if you just don't want to do IVF? As usual, I've got the most recent data for you. Stay tuned. Why is this therapy used at all? Studies show that compared to continuing to have intercourse alone or using fertility medication alone, the combination of fertility medication with IUI improves the chances for getting pregnant each month. For most people, however, the pregnancy rates are not as high as with IVF. As an infertility patient, there are two important things you would like to know. First, does the chance for pregnancy go down with every failed month? And second, is there a point at which IUI stops working completely? To learn the answers to these questions, you need to study a large number of people, and you need to have a large number of people continue the same treatment if they don't become pregnant. These are difficult studies to do. Many people will get discouraged and stop treatment or switch to something like IVF. Recently, however, doctors from several fertility clinics in the U.S. published this study. It involved over 18,000 patients who completed over 35,000 fertility medication and IUI cycles. Here's the breakdown of how many patients completed each round of treatment. As you would expect, the number completing treatment decreased as some couples became pregnant and some dropped out. However, there were still 379 patients who tried an eighth attempt. About half the patients were under the age of 35 and about half were older. About half were normal weight and about half were overweight or obese. About one-third used oral medications, and 45% used injections, and the rest used a combination. So what were the results? The chance of becoming pregnant on each try ranged between 14 and 16%. There wasn't any drop-off as patients started to rack up more failures. In other words, the chance for pregnancy on the seventh or eighth try was about the same as it was on the first or second try. The researchers also analyzed what the cumulative chance for pregnancy would be over eight tries. In other words, if you added up all the people who became pregnant on all eight tries, what percentage of the initial group would have eventually been successful? In this study, about 75% of people eventually conceived. A couple of important limitations here. Even though this was the largest study of this topic to date, the number of people doing a sixth, seventh, or eighth attempt was still small. This could have made it more difficult to determine if the chance for pregnancy was actually lower. Second, we don't know if the people who did not continue treatment were the same as those that did. It is possible that poorer prognosis patients were more likely to drop out. That would make the pregnancy rates for the later cycles look better. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. According to the best available data, it is reasonable to try more than just a few cycles of fertility medication and IUI. The pregnancy rates appear to be stable through several tries. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.